Pirate Podcast.
What's that, buddy?
So, cat guys make me so uncomfortable.
You know I own 3 fucking cats, right?
No, so Mrs. Blackbeard, she said something interesting that, like, cats have, like, this parasite in them, and, like, it affects their host. And I bet you, on God, that cats, people that like cats, are just infected.
No, cats are cool, man.
You think cats are cool?
I do. I mean, I love my dog more than my cats.
Yeah, but people who are like, no, fuck dogs. Cats are where it's at. Like, you have low T.
No, here's the thing. So cats.
Not that there's anything wrong with that.
Right. No. I mean, there is. But go get yourself checked out.
I'm going to get my hormones.
Being a little bitch.
I'm going to be honest with you. I'm running up to 30. I'm going to get my hormones checked next time we go.
Yes.
Next time I go.
I think everyone should.
I'm also going to, like, just stop working out and, like, try. I'm going to try to flag it. You said that there's like a massive issue with that, right? So they bet for.
Correct. Because what they don't want is some gym brony to show up and be like, you know, everyone's got their fucking genetic limit, right? What they don't want you to go in at your genetic limit and be like, okay, this is the thing I need to take the next step.
Right, right. So here's the thing. I want to go even farther beyond.
Unlimited power!
I think it would be just exciting just to, like, even if you get it, like, not through a doctor, I would totally do it.
Would you?
Yeah.
How much would you really be willing to pay for it, though?
How often do you have to get a shot?
Every 2 weeks.
$100.
I think it's more than
that. I think that's a little expensive. I think $50. How much do you think those guys have to pay for
it? I really don't know, but I'm guessing, like, so do you know who Liver King is?
Yeah, I'm familiar with the Liver King.
So the Liver King, he just came out. You know how much he was spending on a monthly basis? It was like $8,000 to $10,000.
That guy's fucking ridiculous, though.
He is. He is a fucking squishy water balloon of mass.
Here's the thing is like, I'm cool if you take steroids. I don't care. I don't personally. I honestly think in this day and age, people have to say they don't care, but, like,
you know, every actor takes steroids. 100%.
All the actors, when they go and they do their routine, they're like, oh yeah, I got ripped in 9 months. They're on testosterone. They're on TRT, human growth hormone.
You'd be stupid if you didn't.
They're fucking on all the cycle. Yeah. Yeah, it's their career. They have to look sharp when it comes, especially. Imagine how good that makes them feel, too.
100%. Here's the thing. Every Marvel superhero, all of them, even fucking Robert Downey Jr.
Yeah.
Takes shit.
Even when they're not, like, ripped, they're on.
No, here's the thing, because that's not the point. The point is that it's their job to get from blank to blank for their roles, and so, you know, they're fucking shooting up.
Yeah, 100%. I think I would definitely do it. I definitely, next time I go see a doctor, I'm gonna, like, yo, check my hormones. Do you think he's immediately gonna know, though?
No. I think here's what you're gonna tell him. You're gonna say
we're rolling, right?
Yeah, we're fucking rolling.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, we're rolling. No. You fucking tell him that, hey, I, you know, am having performance issues in the bed. Dead serious.
Just that's okay.
I'm having performance issues in the bed. I'm emotional. And I just feel like I'm being sensitive to everything.
Grinding through life.
No, because they don't want to think you have depression.
So you got to be very careful.
You just say, I think I'm being sensitive to everything. And say, you know, I think my hormones might be messed up. Can you please check?
Okay.
And I do think that there's subconsciously, like, there was a study I found that said that it's like 40% of guys our age have low T.
Right.
And I'm curious if
do you think
why
our,
that is.
Our grandparents, though, at 30 had low T?
No.
What do you think that's about?
So I think it's for a couple of reasons. I think growing up, and tell me if I'm wrong here, I think I spent a lot of time inside. I think I watched a lot of TV. I think I played a lot of video games. I mean, granted, I went outside and played and shit and rode my bike and did all that as well. But I think our parents and the grandparents, they had to play outside. They went outside from the second they fucking got home from school to the second they went to bed, running around doing shit. That wasn't me. I did, like, an hour, maybe 2 hours.
So, well, here's what's interesting. When I grew up, I was coming from, like, a rural suburban town. My mom was a stay-at-home mom, but she, like, straight up locked me up. Like, locked me outside of the house. Mm-hmm. She also locked my fridges because I was a little fat boy. I don't know. If I told you that.
Fucked. I didn't know that.
She put a giant chain. And so, like.
No, she did not.
Yeah, around both my fridges. We had one in the basement. Here's the problem, though. Instead of just buying healthy foods, she would just buy fucking.
Because she wanted to eat the shit.
Yeah. She just wanted to eat the pudding, soda, chips. And then, like, I definitely was an obese child. Like, if I showed you a photo.
Well, I mean, I was also an obese
child. But I was fat as fuck. And
so. What was your heaviest?
When I was a kid, I think I always rolled, like, morbidly. Like, close to morbid. My heaviest I ever was probably, like, 17, 18. I moved out here and with my parents, and I just didn't have a job. I was complete neat. Are you familiar with the term neat?
Yeah.
Okay. So not employed, educated, or trained, right? Just for our listeners. So I was neat, and I just had no motivation. Got, you know, dropped out of high school, an alternative high school, mind you. Moved out here, didn't want to go back to high school, just playing League of Legends every day, and just eating corn chip and popcorn. Like, I just carb heavy.
Yeah.
And I got to probably 275, maybe 280, because I stopped weighing myself at 270. And I think I probably slipped a little bit more than that. And what's interesting is right around then I got kicked out of the house because I was just not doing anything in my life. I'd work a job, and then I'd get quit. I don't want
to
do it.
Because you didn't want to work. There was nothing forcing you to work.
Right, there was nothing forcing me to work. So I got, and I just remember my parents be like, yo, you're a leech. Get the fuck out. And we just, you know, you butt heads when you stay up late and you kind of devolve into like Gollum. And I think I was like in a really bad place. So I got kicked out, and that was the best thing that could have ever happened for me. I moved back to where I was from. I mailed my car, took a Greyhound bus. Scary as shit, by the way. Scared the shit out of me.
Well, we talked about it, about Greyhound, but we'll get to that in a little bit.
Yeah. So I took the Greyhound, and I lost all the weight. I got down to like 170. So I like lost 100 pounds.
That's solid, yeah.
And I think you got to do it before you're 25. I think you got to lose the weight before you're 25 or you're locked in. Because like you were saying, you start to lower your test, mm-hmm. and that's it. That's your time zone for when you can lose weight.
I do think that also partly that goes into it, and I could be wrong here. I could be making shit up. But I do think, if you noticed, over the last, like, few decades, people have gotten taller and people have gotten just naturally bigger. And I do think there's something, some kind of growth hormone that's either in chickens, cows,
milk. I think you're right.
But I think because of that, there's probably also some estrogen levels that get bumped up as well.
So I think we're also eating more diverse foods, like, every year. Like, the American diet was very, very simple, maybe in the 60s. High fat, high red meat, food. Testosterone boosting
thrives
foods,
on,
right?
Yeah.
And also, like, these are food for like hard workers, right? And everything's getting more and more automated. Even in the office, you had to like carry stuff a little bit, and now it's all virtual, right? We don't do any physical activities unless we opt to, and no one's gonna proactively opt to. But yeah, when I was a kid, my mom, she would lock me out of the house and say, you're not coming home till sundown. To be fair, I think that created like a codependency with the PlayStation 2. Whenever I had an opportunity to stay inside, all I wanted to do was sit on my couch, eat popcorn or corn chips and salsa, because my dad had a garden, so he would make salsa. Really good shit, like the best salsa. Pico de gallo, and I would just pig the fuck out. Chains came off, I would just go to fucking town. I don't think that I have a healthy relationship with food to this day. Would you consider that I'm fat?
No.
But I'm definitely like bigger, right?
Yeah.
I'm husky.
Right.
But I'm kind of strong too, so it's a good balance.
I think you're like me. I think you fluctuate.
I fluctuate a lot.
I definitely feel like I'm fat right now, though, and that's why I need to get my shit figured out.
Understood. And you know what? I think I'm glad that you're taking the steps that you need to. I think that you are making me want to also investigate further, right? But my mom locked me out, so I did a lot of biking. I used to bike 20 miles every day when I was a kid. Not even kidding. I'd bike over to go see girls.
Oh, no. 100%. I was the same way, man. Like, when I was probably in high school, like, my freshman
high school is where it started to slow down.
7th, 8th, 9th, and 10th grade, before I got my license.
Okay.
I used to ride my bike all everywhere. And it's funny because, like.
Out here?
Yeah, okay. I got back into biking. That's how I lost all of my weight originally, was I was doing a bunch of biking.
I know, I saw it takes on the gram, yeah.
Yeah, it takes time, though, to get those muscles feeling good again, though.
Does it?
Yeah, fuck yeah, because if you try to ride a bike right now, you would hate it.
You think so?
Yeah, it would take 2-3 weeks for you to at least be like, because those first 2-3 weeks suck.
You don't think that there would be like any like spark of liberation knowing that I can, you know, you can obtain what you did as a child?
No, 100% there is. But I'm saying like there's just muscles that you don't use walking and doing it your day to day that you use on a bike. So like
when I go to the gym, I don't like the bikes.
Maybe that's
part of
part of it. It's the same thing. It's going to be exactly the same thing. Your body's going to feel weird biking. But after, like I said, after 2-3 weeks, that pain or that, like, this sucks goes away. And then it gets, like, then you start building, like, that runner's high. You started running.
Yeah.
And
so I hate it, by the way.
Do you still hate it?
No, you know what's crazy? I ran for the first time, and I did my loop, because I run, like, you know, I live around here.
Right.
I run a loop at a park with a pond. And at first, it's, you know, it's dark, and I couldn't keep up with any of the guys. I still can't quite keep up with them, but, because they run, they want to enter into competitions and stuff.
Right.
But they push you. They're like, oh, do another lap. I was able to do a loop and a half, and I think I could have even gone a solid 2 loops. It's feeling a lot better.
Good.
I feel a lot better. And because I stay active when I'm not running, I don't feel like I'm losing any running gains. Where I think people are like, oh, well, you have to run twice a week consistently. I'm running maybe once or twice a week, but I feel like I'm not losing the gains if I'm doing jiu-jitsu or I'm in the gym. I don't feel like it's reversing down. But
right.
About running, or about biking, excuse me, when I was a kid, I never paid for a bike. I would find a bike, someone would just throw out a completely working bike where I'm from, and I would just fish it out of the garbage, and that was my bike now. And I would hang on to my bikes. I had like 10, no, not 10, I think we had like 5 bikes in total with my whole family.
Okay.
And I would just pick a bike that I wanted, and I collected bikes. Like, it wasn't nothing. Oh, this bike's being thrown out. It's my bike now. I look now on like OfferUp and stuff, bikes are expensive.
Oh, dude. Well, they've gone down. They have gone down a little bit. But yeah, when I was looking for a bike right when the pandemic started.
How much did your bike cost?
$600.
That's not bad. Your bike looks nice too.
Thanks, man. I have a Trek. Yeah. It's,
okay.
Or not. I'm sorry, not a Trek. I have a Schwinn. So it's a nice bike.
That's a better than a Trek, huh? It's a step
they're,
up.
They're both the same.
They're on the same? Okay.
But it's nice.
High mid?
Yeah. And
like
it's
good
nice.
Starter?
Exactly. And what's nice is mine's like a hybrid. So like there's actually a spring underneath the seat. So that's super nice. And like it's just super adjustable. Super cool.
What I want to do though is while I love mountain biking, I've gone a couple times. Mountain bikes are just completely outside of my price zone. They're just so expensive. I definitely at some point want to get a mountain bike, but I'm looking more towards a road bike because I like the opportunity to bike to work, right?
Right.
And just not even to save gas, but just to stay fit.
You want a road bike, but
I want a road bike.
And here's why. You, as someone who hasn't rode a bike in a long time, you want the lightest bike possible.
Right. Here's the thing is I tried to bike with a mountain bike recently. I'd say maybe 2 years ago when I mean recently is I had a mountain bike, but when I moved, I got rid of it. And I was biking around with the mountain bike, and it was an awful experience. And I was like, I don't remember. Maybe that's what you're talking about. But I was like, I don't remember biking being this awful. And then I realized growing up, all I had was road bikes.
Right.
So it's completely different. They're lighter. They're almost designed for pavement, where mountain bikes are designed for dirt.
Right. Well, so like and it's funny because when I first started riding my bike and getting back in shape, I actually borrowed my dad's bike for a bit, and he has like a nice, like a really nice bike. It's a mountain bike.
Okay.
And it's heavier though. So when I switched over to my bike, which is a road bike, I instantly was like, this is so much better because it's so much lighter and
right.
Just more easier to go. But hey, buddy, do you hear that?
What is that?
It's time for what's cracking around the world.
All right, let's find out. Run it back.
All right, bud. There's a few things going on for sure. So number one, have you heard about all these UFOs that have been getting shot down?
We've been kind of slowly escalating on this.
Okay, so
yeah.
You remember the first week, yes, the balloon thing happened. It was China. We
right.
can confirm. Secondly, I wasn't sure if it was a different device. It was. They've shot down 4 so far.
Well, so I was talking to someone yesterday, and they said that these balloons have been spotted even when Trump was in office.
Correct. So the first one was confirmed it was a balloon. The other 3, they don't know if they're balloons or not.
Maybe because they know we're about to enter a world war.
No, so what? So I don't think that's what it is. So hypothetically, or...
You think they're aliens?
No.
Do you believe
no.
in aliens?
Yeah.
But do you believe aliens would actually, like, are as advanced as us?
They could be.
I don't think they are. I think that we're one of the older species. The Earth is, what, 6 billion years old? The universe is, what, like 12? So the thought process is, like, I feel like we're an older species.
Yeah, but think about it. We're not, though. Because if you look at, like, from a percentage standpoint, how long humans have been here versus how long the Earth has been here, we're, like, 0.0001%.
I don't know. I also don't feel like, I don't know. I just personally feel like most alien species don't end up, I don't think that sentience is, I don't think sentience is what evolution is looking for. I think evolution is ultimately looking for survival of the fittest, and intelligence is a factor, sure, But I think being able to be self-aware doesn't necessarily make we just kill ourselves now. Now we have suicide.
Correct. But I do think here's why I think this. I think at a certain point, Earth is going to become uninhabitable. Okay?
Okay.
And because I think the Earth is going to become uninhabitable, at that point, we're going to have to fucking look for somewhere. We're going to have to... What's the movie with Matthew McConaughey?
Interstellar.
We're going to have to interstellar this bitch, and we're going to have to fucking Murph and get the fuck out of here.
Oh, my God. That movie was weird.
It is. I love it. But my point being is because that's going to happen, think about it. I'm assuming some other alien... You can't tell me in this huge universe that we have, some other alien species hasn't run into this problem already and is looking for just somewhere to go. I'm not saying they've come to Earth. I'm not saying
that's
that.
That's fair. That's fair. I think if there are alien species, that it's more likely that they would come to destroy us than come in peace.
I don't think they would even come to destroy us. I think they're just looking for an uninhabited water planet live on.
Do you think that they would even want to throw hands, or do you think they'd be like, oh, we're going to pass, we're going to go
depends how many there are.
We're going to...
If we're talking like...
Here's the thing, though. Think about it this way, though. If they're really looking just to grow food and like find another sustaining planet, why would they even want to rumble?
Well, that's what I'm saying, though.
They would just pass over.
Well, it depends. You say that, but as humans, we dominate every other species there is as well.
Right, that's true.
When we think about it, like, the United States was all vegetation and shit. We said, oh, this is fucking land. Let's take it.
Fair enough. Do you think that that these UFOs are Russians or Chinese? Or
I think it's a combination of a bunch of things. So what ended up happening with this is two things. One, I guess they've been up there for a while. And something happened where we just tweaked our satellite system in order to see all this stuff. And okay. Now that's why they're popping off left and right. It's not because they haven't been up there this whole time. It's because we just started like actually looking into and tracking it.
I feel like that's probably not true. I feel like we've certainly been looking for them.
No, I'm telling you, like I saw a whole news thing that said that I think it's because of the Chinese balloon that we adjusted it. Because they're so high up, dude.
That's wild to me, though. I couldn't even imagine that the United States government hasn't been, like, looking for this. Oh, no, one. And then now all of a sudden they're finding all of these?
Yeah.
The incompetency, man. That's actually pretty bad. Maybe you're right. I can see giant bureaucratic systems holding it back. What else is going on?
So, just finishing up on that, and then we're going to move on. Okay. Biden says he's going to speak to China's Xi about the balloon incident. So, that's...
Winnie the Pooh.
Okay. Yes, love it. Georgia's grand jury reports that when Trump fucking spoke with Georgia, that at least one person committed perjury. So that's cool.
What do you mean?
It just said that at least one person committed perjury on it. So we'll see what happens.
Really?
Then. Yeah, man. Wow.
Does that mean it's going to get redone?
We'll find out. I don't know.
Interesting.
Also, did you hear about this train derailment? Have you heard about all these train derailments?
First of all, the Ohio?
Yes.
Oh, did you hear about Tucson?
I did hear about Tucson.
I think it's coordinated. What do you think?
You think it's fucking coordinated?
I think it's coordinated.
Dude, maybe.
I was originally born in Ohio.
Were you really?
Yeah.
I didn't know that. No. No, I mean, I was always born here, so it's hard to say.
I was born in Ohio, and then I lived in the East Coast. I moved more north. I lived in the East Coast most of my life. But I only lived there until I was, like, 7. And it's not terrible there. It's not terrible. It's just kind of backwoods.
I'm sure there's nothing to do there.
No, I wouldn't actively want to live there. I try to live in the West. You know, what do you think we talked about this? I try to... stay to the West for the rest of my life.
Right. No, but, yeah, man, that's pretty much...
Do you think that they're terrorist attacks?
No, I don't.
Here's the thing, though. Like, my brain goes, if I was an attacker...
We're overdue for a war, though.
Yeah, 100%. If I was Russia or China, right? If I wanted to derail supply chains, I would, but I wouldn't do it in a way that... Like, I'm not like Al-Qaeda where I want the U.S. to know that I'm powerful. I would know that I'm powerful, and I would want the last thing for them to know... is that I did it because I don't want a word to pop off, but I would 100% try to divert
their No one's attacking the United States, though. That'd be stupid. No offense. The only way that anyone would ever attack the United States is if you got, like, the top seven or eight countries. The top G.
What do you think about Tate right now in prison? Do you think he did it? Do you think he's do you think he...
Do you want my honest answer or do you want my real answer?
I want both.
Okay. So, I partly think it's all bullshit.
Okay. That's a fair take. I think that that's a possibility.
I think it's all bullshit, but then also part of me is kind of like, fuck, they're just coming out with evidence.
Here's the thing. I think that he did it, but I don't know if the spin on how he did it is illegal. Like,
so, yeah.
Like, convincing women that that you love them and then getting them to work for your cam service is shady and like morally that's wrong, but is that against the law?
Well, here's the other thing with it, too, is he straight up... like, there was a girl that came out and...
There's also a lot of girls coming out saying that's not true.
Correct. There was a girl that came out and he asked her to be on cams and she was all for it. I guess she was an English girl. And first day, she just got trashed. Like, fucking trashed. And he said, you can't do that. This is a business. You got to keep it professional. And she pretty much told him, fuck you. And so he said, okay, you need to get the fuck out of my house. And so... what ended up happening then is she's like, I'm not fucking going anywhere, blah, 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 blah. Well, he literally, like, I shouldn't say he grabbed her, but he did. He, like, put his arms around her shoulders, said, you need to get out to my house.
And pushed her out.
Well, it was all fine. Everything was fine. Like, 2 weeks later, oh, I guess she threw up all over his shit. Okay. And so 2 weeks later, she said, like, well, you owe me money. And he goes, I'm not paying you anything. You only worked for 10 minutes, and you threw up on all my shit and ruined my stuff. I'm not paying you for this. Well, then she went to the police. He's already been dealing with the police a few times, but
This is why he was trying to, like, move to Dubai.
Right. So she went to the police and said that
Dubai
he...
Dubai would put up with the cam girl business, though.
Probably not. But he hit her. And so he went through, like, a year and a half of legal things.
Okay.
And they finally, she admitted, well, no, he didn't hit me. But he definitely touched me to get me out of the house.
I just think, like, he's definitely walking the line.
Right. He's also, like, from Europe, and so things are a little different over there.
Right.
It's not like it is in the United States where, no offense, a lot of women are fucking privileged. And
That's true. Here's the thing, though. In Europe, though, they're a little bit more traditional. So I also think the type of women he's probably getting in Europe that are traditional but willing to do this are probably really down their luck. So he's definitely playing off of that. And I'm not saying that that's ethically wrong or not. I mean, personally, I don't think I would partake in the business that he's partaking in. I don't think it's necessarily super more morally okay. But at the same time, he's just an absolute hustler. Like, in his mind, he thinks he's, like, the coolest guy in the world. And,
right.
Like, he thinks of himself as, like, an absolute, like, wealthy elite. Here's the thing. Real wealthy people, they don't flaunt their money.
Correct.
They don't try to act as cool as he is because it's part of his brand. At this point now, he has to be this cool in order to keep making money.
I also do think, though, part of it is a show. He's putting on a show for people.
I think he's, like, a WWF villain. I do think
Correct.
He's making up how evil he is.
No,
it's a character.
No publicity. What's the word I'm looking for?
Publicity.
Publicity is bad publicity.
The problem is that's not going to help his case.
Correct.
Now he's literally painted himself as the supervillain, like Correct. The WWF supervillain. At this point, it's going to go downhill for him, but...
I do think, though, the whole thing with, like, OnlyFans and cam girls and all this stuff, that I personally believe this. It goes back to our conversation we were having earlier where, you know, just, like, how do you convince someone to make minimum wage or convince someone, you know, we were talking about inner cities earlier.
Right.
And just a little bit of backstory. And I said, you know, it's really hard to teach someone from the inner city that, hey, you should go work at McDonald's for $10 an hour when you can make $10,000 a month selling drugs.
Here's the thing. I do think that they know the risk reward.
Of course. Absolutely.
I also think that the only reason that they choose to step over that line is because it's glorified in those communities.
Right. And I have a friend who we're not going to name. Let's just call her Peggy. Peggy the Pirate.
Okay.
And she has an OnlyFans account.
Really?
And she does. And she's okay. She's not the most attractive woman in the world. But the point is though, is that she's done.
Have you looked at
it? I haven't. No.
Okay.
No, I haven't.
I'd be so tempted.
No.
Whoever you're talking about, like.
I've already seen her naked before.
Okay.
It's okay.
Fair enough.
But and she was talking to us about it the other day. And.
But if you didn't, you totally would look.
I don't think I would. I think I'm chill. Okay. But she, like, someone gave her, like, $2,000 to fucking go to the store, buy a cake, and then smoosh it with her foot.
That's weird.
And, like, she's done a bunch of foot stuff.
Do you think that that's creating, like, a... and I'm not saying that people don't earn their money, but do you think that that's creating, like, a kind of a vacuum where people feel like that they don't have to earn, especially, like, pornography and stuff like that, where they don't have to earn and go out and, like, earn these kinks that they want? Like, now they can just pay for it?
Well, the problem with it is, in general, is, at least this is my opinion.
Most people in, like, the 50s, they would have to really find someone who's into that and work really hard to get them to like them.
I think there's a giant wage gap. I think there's a lot. There's a lot of people on the lower class, and which, like I said, if you can make $2,000 for 5 minutes of work, would you do it?
Yeah, but it destroys your...
They don't think about the consequences.
Also, what I was saying about the inner cities was simply this: that the inner city, these people who are in charge of the Treasury Department in inner cities, they make money based off of the schools that are with the worst grades.
Right.
Well, inner cities are some of the highest paid and financed schools in the United States, but they have some of the lowest performing grades. And the reason is, I think, because they keep them low so they can keep getting money so they can line their own pockets.
Right, we talked about this. We both think that they should be on, like, a performance plan kind of thing.
Not the top performers, because then it could be considered racist, right? But just the people who are...
No, improvement.
People who have the most improvement. So that way, only the people who are low building get the most finance.
It's just like any kind of investment. Here's the thing. If I'm going to give you $10 million a year,
right?
Let's just say, I'm going to give you $10 million a year, and you're giving me worse results, I'm going to stop funding it. Obviously,
this project isn't working, though. Right.
If the project isn't working, let's actually cut your funding. And now you're making $1 million a year, and actually your numbers are going up. Great. Now we can look back and give you more money.
Right. And I guess you're also not going to invest in people who aren't moving at all, even if they are making way better grades.
Well, granted, I'm not against being stagnant necessarily. And what I mean by that is, if I give you $7 million a year, and you guys are all averaging a B minus, let's just say, okay?
Sure.
Everyone in your school is averaging a B minus. Okay, we'll leave you at $7 million here. You're not showing any improvement.
Right,
you guys aren't taking that initiative to get it up.
We'll just leave it as it is. I think that's fair. I'd like to see, and I think that if you do that, it would improve the quality of life of these kids, because I think that they're being taken for a ride.
Absolutely. No, I 100% agree, man. I just think that, and I will say this, just ending last note on just the whole OnlyFans kind of thing, is that I do think that there's a lot of women in particular that don't have a lot of skills but are naturally good to look at.
Sure.
And here's the problem.
That is a skill. I mean, you can have biological skills, and I think in a way people forget that the fact that if you are an entertainer, sometimes that people that are entertainers have innate biological advantages.
I disagree that it's a skill, though.
I think it's interesting. So when I look at skill, I look at something that you could do that someone else can't do, and I don't look at it as, like, it needs to be learned. It could be innate. Like, some people have a skill where they're really, really flexible, so they become, like, acrobats, right? I think that there's some biological skills, and I think that that is a skill. My only problem with that, and what I worry about, is good for them. Let them do whatever they want.
Yeah, I mean, I don't give a fuck.
I'm very libertarian
on
that. My only concern is that what happens as a society in 50 years from now when they're all 60?
And that's what I was getting to. Is my point is, that's why I don't think of it as a skill. Because realistically speaking, 15 years from now, not even 60, 15 years from now, if these girls are, let's say they're 22. Okay.
Oh, hold on. If you're a pro video game player, you have great dexterity, and I cut off both your hands, now you can't be a pro video game player, and that was a biological ability to do that. That's all I'm saying. I think biology can be partially a skill.
Okay. I understand where you're coming from, but I think even if you're a great video game player and I cut off both hands or just thumbs?
Both hands.
If I cut off both of your hands, you'll probably adapt to some other kind of video game.
Fair enough. Or you could become a video game coach.
Right. There's something you can contribute to it. You
maybe
can't
those,
contribute
ladies,
good looks.
Maybe those ladies could become coaches.
To what?
I don't know. I guess none of these girls needed it to begin with. I don't know. I just think like I
it's
worry.
Easy money is what the problem is.
I'm okay with easy money, but I just don't think it's sustainable. And then I worry about the tax, like taking care of these people once they can no longer use those.
Exactly, money. That's my concern.
What does society do
when they turn like 40? Let's say when they turn 40, and people are not going to pay for it anymore because there's going to be the next crop.
Depends.
And it's going to be the next crop.
Sure.
Let's be honest.
Fair enough.
People are going to move off people's attention or whatever. Now, what are they going to do? Now, instead of going and learning a skill or going, instead of going and learning a skill or learning something at a job, now they have to, maybe they can be marketing or maybe they can do something that does attribute to it. I'm not saying that, but I'm saying there's going to be a set of people that they have nothing now.
I definitely feel like other people have to pick up the slack.
Yeah.
Yeah, and that is a concern. What do you think? What do you think about, like, do you think OnlyFans almost banned everyone, remember? All of those they were going to just do for other stuff. I wonder where that came from, just maybe out of left field. But
no, for sure. All right, buddy. Well, I think it's time.
It's time.
We should go into the sparrow's nest.
Let's take a look.
All right, bud. So I think we should just bust out two of them. I think you're cool.
100%.
Okay. So the first
one. God, for real, for real.
Change. Change. All right. So the first one, $10 million. But you can never wear shoes and or socks ever again. Would you do it?
Ooh. Oh, wow. I can wear flip-flops?
Nope.
Oh, nothing.
You got to be barefoot.
Bilbo Baggins and stuff.
Yep.
I could become one of those like people who are like, and just preach like I'm connected to the energy of the earth. And I could be one of those people who like gets really hardcore calluses. I wouldn't worry about disease, though. Like, you can't walk in. There's a lot of places. You're a millionaire, right? Granted.
$10 million.
There's a lot of places you can't access. Here's the thing. I'm going to just real time run this scenario in my head.
Yep.
$10 million, I guess I build like my dream, like off-grid, you know, compound. Mm-hmm. I could have like solar, wind, thermal. I guess I could have all that. I could have crops. I could have small businesses. I feel like that's very, very limiting. I would say it's interesting. I don't know if any amount of money actually would make me say yes.
Damn. Okay.
I think I would need to at least be able to wear sandals. And I would.
Well, yeah, but that's not a challenge.
Let me flip it for you.
Uh-huh.
Flip flops the rest of my life for $500,000.
Yes.
Yes.
That's not that, but that's taking the whole thing away from it, though. This is $10 million.
I'm going to be honest with you. Like, I'm really thinking about, like, I can't wear hiking boots anymore. So hiking is going to become a massive problem. I can't go hunting.
You would get used to it.
I think our ancestors even wore leather shoes.
Not all of them. There's certain tribes that still wear.
I don't
want
to be the liver king. I don't want to be super tribal. Like, I like my footwear.
So the answer is, for me, is yes. The answer is 100%.
Okay, bullshit. Explain. What is your lifestyle that you're building around this?
I'm going to rock a wheelchair.
Oh, that's genius!
Game changer, bro.
But how are you gonna go hunting?
I'll get a fucking fancy wheelchair that lets me fucking rock, like the one with the tread on it.
I guess you could get an ATV and stuff. Yeah. Would you be worried about like getting bit? Or?
I would get used to it.
Maybe. I
would cry all the way to the bank. All right.
Maybe.
No, but I
would have to think about that a little bit. How about this? Pocket that one for next one. As of right now, that's a no.
Okay.
I would still rather live in the fucking, for a year, live in the garbage dump.
The dump? Whatever. That's a good one, right? All right, I'm going to spin it again. Here we go. You ready?
Yeah.
All right. If you had to have sex with an animal, what animal would it be and why?
That's a super hard question.
There's no money involved? No money involved. You just have to pick something.
Can I get like one free respin?
Do you want a respin? You don't like this question?
Here's the thing. I wouldn't though.
No, if you have to pick one.
You have to build this better. Like, are you gonna get killed?
No, you just have to pick one. No. I purposely did not give you an out on this question. I just want you to know. If you want, I can respin. We can skip this one.
I don't think I'd rather die.
You can't. That's not an option.
I'd rather die.
You want me to respin?
Yes.
Are you tapping out?
I'm tapping.
Okay,
I'm
we're going to spin. All right. That's a good question, though.
Yeah.
I purposely fucking reworded it like that, just so you know. Okay. What third world country would you be a dictator for?
Oh, that's so easy. I would want... Here's the thing. People sleep on the third world... Speaking of Andrew Tate, people sleep on the third world country in the Balkans. Anywhere in the Balkans, you can get some real nice European like and Middle Eastern lifestyle where it's like a perfect like melting pot, right?
Fair.
Probably Croatia. Is Croatia third world or second world?
Honestly, I have no idea.
Would you consider Italy first world or second world?
First world.
Really?
Italy?
Yeah.
It's Italy.
Okay.
Is Paris a first world or a second world country?
Somewhere in the Balkans. Somewhere in the Balkans.
Okay.
Yeah, anywhere in the Balkans or anywhere in like a satellite Russian country. People forget that like a lot of those countries
I don't think Russia counts.
No, I didn't say Russia.
You literally said a satellite Russian country.
Well, yeah, like one of the countries that used to be in the USSR.
I got you.
Any one of those countries would be a massive...
It'd be really fucking cold, though.
I'm okay with that. Because you're a dictator.
There's one obvious answer.
What is it for you?
It's definitely North Korea.
Oh, yeah.
I'm just going to take it over. He set it up for me. I'm just going to...
I'd be worried I'd get assassinated all the time. See, in the Balkans, I don't know if I would.
No, I'd be the dopest dictator ever. I'd just be like, all right, United States, I'm your ally now.
Then you're not first world. I think you immediately get bumped up to second world when you're not
the United States. We're still going to suck.
Do you think that the U.S. already... I don't know if you know this, but the U.S. airdrops food into North Korea.
They have to, otherwise they would die.
What happens if we just stop taking care of them?
They would all die.
Why don't we just do that?
Well, we will. It's on my agenda for when I become the dictator of North Korea. We'll just kill everybody. It's
fine. No, I think a Balkan country for sure. Or a satellite USSR country. I think that would be so much fun, dude. 100%. I want you to know...
If you were a dictator, though, realistically speaking...
What?
Like, would you just want to fuck shit up?
I would get a harem, number one. First thing I'd do is I'd get a harem. No, I'm just going to run it back. I'd get a harem. I would definitely, like, have a collection of, like, classical vehicles. Like, I'd have, like, all of the...
Yeah.
The really nice, fancy, like, Mercedes, the ancient Mercedes and everything. I would want, like, a plane. I would want, like... I just think I would be, like, an Indiana Jones villain. You know, like,
I understand.
I feel like I would be an Indiana Jones villain, and I would 100% smoke cigars all the time. I would be constantly drunk. I'd have an amazing collection of suits. I would be the Andrew Tate thinks he is or wishes he was.
I would be the face.
Yo, you want the marble statues?
I would be the face, and I would 100% hire a bunch of people just to run it for me.
Yeah, but you want to be like you want to have your like you want them to think you're God.
Yes.
For me, I want to like travel through the town and people to give me like throw flowers at me.
I want them to believe that I can't poop.
I want them to like know that
they call me supreme leader.
You want to be a supreme leader. I want them to be like afraid of me, but in like a we really like this guy because like I don't just because like I'm famous and rich in like a really impoverished country. Like I'm the rich guy and no one else is rich.
Well, you could totally pull that off. Like if you just let's say there's $10 billion all across the country, right? Right.
You own 9 of that.
You own 9.5, and you're like some dude's like struggling to buy a corn dog, and you're like,
you just buy
$300, sir, and he's just like, holy fuck, you just changed my life.
Here's the thing.
You still need to watch your grocery, by the way.
I don't think you ever get assassinated if you're that. Oh yeah, you're like, oh yeah, I'll take care. Oh, this town's not thriving, and you just constantly keep them under pressure.
No, they don't have guns.
No, but listen, you constantly keep them under like an impoverished pressure, and what you do is you slowly.
I have an answer for it.
You slowly release the pressure vents, and you like, oh, I'm gonna go in and buy you this. I'm gonna go in and buy you that. But realistically, if you just redistributed that wealth, everyone would be okay.
I have an answer for it.
I'm going to be truly loved. I don't want them to cry out of fear.
I have an answer for it. It's called all of my military gets taken care of. And if you don't want to be in the military anymore, then you can go live with the poor.
I really think that in like in North Korea specifically, the military is like true knights of ancient times.
Correct.
They're 100% taking
you
care of
you. Want to eat actual meat and like live here and I'll take care of
there's
you?
There's got to be a way.
You have to have a gun and you're going to take care of me. You're going to protect me.
Have you ever seen the Vox documentaries where they sneak into North Korea?
Yeah.
Where the guy hitchhikes?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty excellent. If you haven't seen those videos, definitely watch like Thumbs Up. It's so good. He hikes through China. He hikes from, like, Mexico into Canada. He just hitchhikes. That's something that if I ever, like, lost my job, I'd probably just 100% shoot a YouTube. Would you watch that? Would you watch me doing like hitchhiking across America?
100%. You also know Little Matey. Yeah. He would. That's all he wants to do.
Little Matey, that's ultimately like it is what his life
goal. That's his life goal, is he wants to just travel and go fucking like help people, which is way better than I want. I want to be a dictator.
I can see Little Matey doing that. Like once all his kids are out of the nest, and you know they're all out of the Pirate Cove, and he's ready to like blossom. I could 100% see him just being like
1,000%,
like a rock star, bro.
Yeah, 100%. No, that's awesome, man. All right, bro. Well, you got anything else you want to bring up?
No, just we're both on this weekend, and it's gonna be nice. We're gonna relax, and I'll see you next week for the next Pirate Podcast. I will say that I'm definitely enjoying our time with the Pirate Podcast, and we'll catch you next time, folks.
All right, thanks everybody. Have a good weekend.